It's just something about the healing place. It's almost a religious experience.
It is the environment of care. Building it is the most important calling I can think of.
Mike and I met later in life. We had one of those, you miss the train and you catch the next one and you meet your mate, you know? And it was like we were meant to be. And then he got sick.
My liver started failing big time. And from there, that's how I started at Stanford.
Mike was in the hospital several years ago in the early stages of the building of the hospital. And when we would go on our walks, we'd come down to that far end of the hall, and out that window was this huge hole where they were building. So we would go over there and just kind of watch the progress, and it was cool. We really want to give back. And it got to the point then where we became members of the founding Patient and Family Advisory Council.
The Patient Family Advisory Councils, or PFACs as we call them, are core to the process by which we integrate patient and family voice when we were soliciting feedback.
Usually in this process you talk to the doctors, the nurses, administrative people, housekeeping people, etc., and what they're doing. But here we actually reached out to the people who are the direct people we're serving. They were the owners.
There's nothing more important to us than the health and well-being of our patients. For sure, that means delivering the very best medical care, but it also means having an environment that's nurturing and supports healing and well-being.
We did a lot of work to identify what were the needs that the patients had before we designed what the building would accomplish. When you look at this building and its design, it really is centered around that care experience. What is most important to the patient and the caregivers is part of that environment.
And one of the things that we started out doing was really trying to incorporate principles of design thinking, doing lots of different interviews, observing patients and families as they interacted in our existing buildings, and then adding to the existing design of the hospital. When we were talking to patients, it really became obvious to us that the caregiver was just as much a part of the experience for the patient as we were. And addressing those needs of the family or the caregiver was really important. So that translated into a space that was designed on the third floor of the new hospital that's really dedicated to the family and caregiver experience.
The first floor is where patients and families interact with the building with their shoes on. And the third floor is where you interact with the building with your bedroom slippers on. Patients and families especially, they're there 24/7. This is their home as well. They need places to go for respite. We didn't want that to be a secondary thought in the building.
The third floor has its own vibe. It's the heart of the hospital, and it's where they soften the edges.
It's a place where people can go to find information, do research on a particular diagnosis or condition, and then most importantly, creating a serene environment that allows the caregiver or family member to decompress.
It's woven together art, music, knowledge, spirituality, nature, and it's everywhere on that floor, and it makes all those elements even more powerful. From private rooms to the whole third floor with the meditation room, the gardens. The way this has been designed, I just can't help but feel health and healing. About 4 or 5 years ago, Michael and I separated, and I was here alone. It was a pretty tough time for both of us. I was still coming over to the hospital quite a bit because I was still doing my volunteer work. And every time I came by, I would stop and take pictures. And at that time, it was just the steel structure. And it was my way of communicating with Mike about, look, the new hospital's coming along. Look how much progress is there. It was really kind of symbolic to both of us about the building and reconstructing, and it was very healing for us.
What I've always said about the old hospital, and I know it'll be the same with this new one, is it's a miracle factory. I'm the perfect example. I probably shouldn't be here, which being I wouldn't be here with my wife. And she's funny and I like her.